Hello students of standard 5. We are going to learn chapter 3, The Wise King, part 5. We have seen in the previous class, that king had gone with his courtier to the desert to find out the camel. And he could not reach where the camel was there, because in the desert, on the sand, he could not walk. Jungle is very shady and he was happy there. But when he reached to the desert, he felt very warm, very hot. Sun was blazing and his paws were burning. He was unable to walk. He said, "I don't need to eat the camel meat. I would like to go." And now the courtiers were worried. They were thinking, how can we take this king to the forest? And it is so far. So fox, cunning fox, always you know that he's cunning, he will get some idea. He got idea and he said, "You all wait here, I'm coming." And he ran to the desert, he found the camel and he said, "Camel, my friend, my king has called you, invited you to be his courtier." He said, "I don't know any king here. I know only is that my master for whom I work. I load the things, take and one place to another unload it. That's all I know. I carry the things for my master." But cunning fox was always cunning and he said, "Your master is killed by our king. And now he has set you free. So please, you come, because our king was happy with you and he want to make you courtier in his kingdom." So camel said, "If my master is dead, I'm ready to come." And he went where the king was there. And they saw him and they were very pleased, very happy. And the fox ordered, "King, place it on the back of the camel and let us go." So king sat first, then the fox sat and the leopard sat. And crow flew ahead and all of them went back to the forest. Now they were looking at each other because they were very hungry and tired. So they knew that prey is there, camel is there, they will have. But king understood the friend camel has brought him safely. So he said, "My dear friend, camel, you have been very good and you have brought me safely here. So I also promise to keep you safe and give you food. You can be here as long as you want." And the courtiers were so much shocked. They felt very bad. "We have been so loyal and how can king do this to camel? He is ready to feed and give protection." So they were so much jealous. Then the king said to the courtiers that, "Please go and bring food." He said to them to go and bring food for. And they had no other way. They were frightened of the king. So they went to the forest for hunting. The king then ordered the 3 courtiers to find some food for all of them. They had to obey him. While they were on their way to search for food, they began to discuss what to do. They were not at all happy to hunt. They wanted to have the camel with them food. "I know what we should do. Let us make the camel offer himself to the king and request them that he be eaten." So they said, "We should do such a way that camel also can tell that, please, your majesty, you eat me." And when he says, "We all will act such a way that king should eat him." "That's good idea," said leopard. Crow also said, A very good idea. Narrator. The courtiers then returned to the lion. Your Majesty, we are sorry, but we could not find any food. So they said to the king that, Your Majesty, we did not get any food. Leopard. However, we do not want you to go hungry. Leopard said, we do not want that you should be hungry. So you can have us. So we are all ready for you to eat us. Please choose one of us. So he said that we all are ready. You can eat. So you select whom you want to eat. Narrator. The camel did not want to be left behind. Camel said he don't want it to be left. He also agreed and he said, I too would like to offer myself to you, Your Majesty. So camel said that I am also ready. You can have me too. As soon as they heard this, the three courtiers got ready to pounce on him, but the lion stopped them. As soon as the camel said that, Your Majesty, you can have me too. And as he stopped, all three of them were just ready to attack. Then lion said, stop. You stop, don't eat him. You have all been good and loyal subject. I shall do as you say. I shall eat each of you, one of you, one by one. So he said, now you have been so loyal to me. So great you have been. And you are offering to me to eat. I am ready now. So I can eat all of you, one by one. So be ready. All of them got shocked. And what they did the next? They decided. And they, as soon as heard this lion said this, the three courtiers ran as fast as could do. They offered themselves to the king to be eaten. And when king agreed, so they ran away with their life. They only wanted to trick the camel. Camel should say that, and they were ready to attack. But camel said also, but the king stopped. The lion said, पतला पतला काट दो, उसको चौड़ा क्या है, वो चौड़ा है क्या? हाँ, so he said that I'm ready to eat you all. And then what he did? Run away. All of them, lion, fox and crow, all three of them ran away with their life. So children, you should understand, even friendship, when the difficulty comes, friends leave you. So you should know whom to trust, whom not to trust. The best friend should be your parents. Your parents will never cheat you. They are the best person to be trusted and to make them as your friend. Your difficulty, your happiness, your trouble, your painful things, everything you can share with your parents. Parents will take care of you. They will advise you because they have seen life. The life which you are going through, they have already crossed. They have lived. So they have experience. They will understand you better. Because they are doing for you everything. So they will listen to you too. Okay. Thank you. We'll see you next class. Read the story till now which is taught. Okay, bye.